Hey, Chris Menard here. I recently did a video on one of my favorite functions, an if function. Today, we're going to take the if function and put and with it. We'll also do it with or. I use these all the time. Let's dive in right now. So I have this Excel worksheet running. I have already calculated the total here, which is an auto sum. Next to it on the commission, I've already covered how to do an if statement. Training completed is either yes or no. It is just purely text. In this example, if they have gone over the 8,500 sitting in cell B4 and, keyword is and, they have completed their training, they get an additional year-end bonus of $350. Here we go. I'm over in cell I8. I'm just going to type this one out, but and, or, and if are under formulas, logical, and, if, or. Equal if, tab, and, A-N-D, tab, you can have 64 ands. It doesn't matter what order you put them in, but I like to work from left to right. We've got two conditions. Condition one is cell F8 greater than cell B4. I'm going to press the F4 function key. That needs to be absolute reference. Comma, here is the second and right here. Did they complete their training? Well, that is cell H8 equals, that is text. I'm putting the word yes inside of quotes. It is not case sensitive, capital yes, lowercase yes, it doesn't matter. There is my and. I could continue on, but I'm going to close it. Comma. Notice it says value if true in bold. Well, how much do you want to give them? They're going to get $375 if both of these conditions are true. Comma. What if this condition is false? I'm making this up. No extra bonus. I could put zero. I could leave it blank. Press enter. Hit yes. It's closing the print for you. 375. I should get some no extra bonuses when I double click and autofill it down. And sure enough, I do. There you go. Quick test. This was intentional. This Scott Williams in row 9. Notice the training completed is no. We went back and checked our records. Scott did complete training. I'm going to make it yes. And there is that 375. I am going to do an undo and put it back to no for right now, though. That was an and inside of an if. We can also do an or. Here's your or for you. So not only in column G do they get a percentage commission, and also in column I, we had an and, but we're going to give them another bonus. And this one is, even if you didn't get the 8,500, but if you went to training, because training is important, we're going to give you another $160. I'm making up the numbers, by the way. So here we go with another if, tab, or tab, same 64 arguments. What's argument number one? Is this number greater than cell B4? Absolute reference that for me. Comma, here's your second or. Is the training completed? Yes. Close. Comma. Value of true. I believe I said 160. Comma. I want to blank this time. Just put in your quotes with nothing in between. I'm going to go ahead and close it this time. That is it right there. Press enter. 160. Crosshairs. Double click. Let's do a quick test here. Take a look right here in row number 13. The 7,000 is obviously not over 8,500, but training completed is yes. We went and checked our records, and for Catherine, the answer is no, and it went blank. I'm going to do an undo again, but there you go, using if and if or. I use these all the time. Hope you enjoyed this video. Feel free to subscribe or ring the bell. I appreciate your time. Thank you.